this whole industry of healthcare is that it is important that we learn from other industries that are there. And we have been learning a lot from the aircraft industry, where we improve our healthcare quality by seeing what are the improvements that are there happening in the aircraft industry, and how, though they have reached to a point where they have tried to reach the Six Sigma level that is there. So in that aspect that we are talking about, when it comes to cleaning verification, we have learned a lot from the food safety industry. And that's where this whole technology of understanding cleaning verification comes, because till recently there was a lot of verification validation when it comes to disinfection and sterilization procedures, but we didn't have much for cleaning. So to put light on this, I would like to welcome our dear friend Dr. Ramakant Lavanya, who is the technical support manager for Hygiene India. He has over 11 years of experience in various fields, primarily in the food and safety industry, and recently he's also been supporting the healthcare industry. He has excellent coverage in quality control, quality assurance, research and development, and he's also a lead auditor for ISO 9001:2015. He has also worked in Southeast Asian countries other than India, and during his PhD days, he has also received numerous grants from Government of India. So with this wonderful background, Dr. Ramakant, we would like you to kindly take over the session. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thank you very much for a brief introduction. And before I start my presentation, as I have seen in past presentations from various doctors and experts, that we are talking about the cleaning, the verification, the sanitation, the sterilization, and various methods, designs, and disinfections from Madam Bhatia. And thank you, Madam Bhatia, to give an introduction about the ATP technology in your presentation, so that will be really a good platform for me to introduce about my technology, and very well illustrated by Dr. Shashank as well, because as of now, this very technology is being very, very useful in the food industries as of now for past 20, 25 years. And it is accepted globally very well in verification of hygiene verification for both surface and vessel, as well as final rinse water. So I will be putting some light for having this technology in the hospital care industries as well. So from WHO, we will see that 35% are not associated with these devices, but they are due to other sources of infections. It could be the patient environment, the endoscopes. I'll be focusing another slide for the endoscope, because we also have a very wonderful tool which can verify the exact cleaning and sanitation of the endoscope, which is being adopted in all the hospital industries. And there are various industries which shows that 30% of the endoscopes are inadequately cleaned. And if I take account of the loss, it will be equal to one jumbo jet crash per month in European Union. And HCAI are preventable. So if we see that cleaning is a very key important for, component for infection prevention, which breaks the chain of cross infection. But we would see that generally it gives attention. We have provided very less attention to this aspect, and very little support is provided. Low skills are used in cleaning, because we generally give cleaning as a low weightage, and we understand that we have those facilities, those equipments which can take care of the cleaning. But it is really a very important factor to understand about the cleaning. So there are definitions of cleaning, disinfection, decontamination, sterilization. I am not going into the detail, but I would like to say that these terms are indiscriminate, but the cleaning assumed is equal to the decontamination, which means if we assume a complete cleaning, then we can assume the decontamination. And this decontamination can be measured with the help of ATP technology. So there are controls which are required for the measurements. So if you see, as per NHS UK, cleaning manual defined that the absence of any blood, spillages, stains, and skin plaster is considered to be the most important thing for this particular control. Poor definition are very subjective, which means different things to different peoples. It is not objective and not quantitative. Gives poor quality management information. So ultimately, visual assessment implies cleaning activity has occurred, but gives no information about how well it was performed. Because we all know that in microbiology, it takes at least 24 to 40 years to come to a conclusion whether that cleaning has been done properly or not, because the cleaning part cannot be visualized with the help of naked eyes. So a very well said by H. James Hennington, that measurement is the first step that leads to control and eventually to improvement. So if we can't control something, we can't understand it. And if we can't understand it, we can't control it. And finally, if we can't control it, we can't improve it. So we have to understand all those factors which is involved in the cleaning and sanitation. So talking about directly of the technology, which is very, very relevant in terms of hygiene and sanitation verification, that is the ATP bioluminescence technology. So I will directly come to a very important slide that how actually this technology is working for these kind of industries, whether it is a food industry or it is a hospital care or any hospitality industries. I will quote you a wonderful example for these days that after COVID-19, people generally come to know about what exactly the sanitation means. And they have regularly doing the cleaning of their hands, and after cleaning, they are putting the sanitizers. And as well as these things are going very well into the offices all as well. The best example we have seen in last 1 year is that most of the offices now focusing about the verification of cleaning, because as of now till date, the ATP technology is the only technology which can really give you the real-time monitoring of the hygiene verification. So how actually it works? This ATP technology is basically derived from an insect which is called as firefly. And we have seen in our childhood that an insect which is illuminating in the dark in the evening time. And we usually used to run with that against that firefly. So the science has taken out that chemistry which has occurred in firefly with the activity of its enzyme and its substrate. So what is happening? There is an enzyme called luciferase and its corresponding substrate called luciferin and the ATP. So ultimately what is happening? Whenever we are doing a swab of a particular area or of a particular instrument or any of the device where we want to understand about the efficiency of cleaning and sanitation, then we will do a swabbing. So the swab will extract the ATP from that particular area. And again, this ATP has a very high importance because here you are not only estimating the microbes, but also the soil part, which we have discussed in various presentations. So ultimately what is happening? It is giving you a reflection of both microbial as well as non-microbial ATP. So ATP, when combines with luciferase and luciferin, emits a light. And that light is read by a wonderful machine called luminometer. So basically, we have these hygiene verification tools from Hygiena. So these are the few models. What we can do, what we have to do is, we have to just take the swab from this particular device and put it into this machine. And you can see the swabbing practice is always 4 by 4 inches or 10 by 10 inches, vertically, horizontally, and diagonally. And you have to snap the valve and put this swab into the machine and you get the readings, right? So on the basis of this reading, we can understand what is the level of cleaning. So there are various areas where we can really look into for the verification of this hygiene and sanitation practices. And you can see on the screen that there are almost all the areas where this very technology has a scope. So how this particular technology will help us to understand the cleaning and sanitation verification? As you can see, the light is emitted with a reaction of ATP and enzyme substrate. There will be a light, and that light will be measured in terms of RLU, that is relative light unit. And we can put a standards of pass, caution, and fail. And it depends upon area to area, and the clean zone, non-clean zone, or the red zone, whatever the zone we classify in the hospitals or any of our areas. So basis on the basis of those particular values, we can classify those particular areas for cleaning verification. And you can see the values are more stringent towards the high care areas, while in the public areas, the values are little low. So ultimately, in nutshell, what we would say, the cleaner, we should always focus on the cleaner workplace to give the morale of the staff. We will observe the lax less sickness in the staff and have the more productivity. And we can see these are the gray areas wherein we will find a lot of germs or lot of contamination in different areas. So ultimately, in nutshell, what I would like to say is that though we all know that the cleaning and sanitation is a very key part and important part, and it is the SOP in all hospital care industries, but as of now, there is no such device or a tool which can verify the instant cleaning. So this ATP technology helps very well in the hospital care industries, whether it is any area. And specifically, we have a device, the swab, which goes very well for the endoscopes. So this is all about the ATP technology. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Ramakant. That was a wonderful and crisp talk that was there. So I'll take a quick question now. The question says that, is it valid to check internally or does it need any external validation for this report of ATP testing?
Basically, we can do it validation internally because we have to classify the values of RLUs for our particular areas. Say, for example, we are looking for hand hygiene. So what we can do is we can take the swab before cleaning our hands and then we ask the person to clean and then we can verify. So generally 3 to 5 readings can be taken and that value will define us that what exactly is a value which will be kept for a pass value and which will be kept for a fail value.
Okay. And the question is that, is this being currently accepted in the healthcare? Because I know this has come from the food safety industry, but any regulations that talk about healthcare?
Basically, as of now, very few people in India are adopting this technology. But if you talk about the acceptance globally, various European Union countries are using this very technology in their hospital care, in the child care, home care. So it is using extensively in the Western world. And we all know that unless the Indian scenario doesn't understand about the reflection of Western world results, we do not adapt those technologies. And that is how there was a reluctance in using this technology in food industries as well for past 20 years. And now, if you will ask me about the food industries, it is all food industries, all processing industries who are using this technology very efficiently.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Ramakant, for this wonderful talk.